Hi, everybody. Welcome to Katie in the Morning. I am Katie Page, Director of Member Relations at the National Association of Healthcare Assistants. I got talking to Lori here, and that always stirs up some trouble when the two of us put our heads together. But I asked her, can I do a Katie in the Morning about my personal excitement for CNA Fest? I have been to several NACA conferences over the last 15 years. Actually, after I went to my first one, I believe it was in 2012, in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, there was no stopping me after that. I've been to almost every CNA Fest or NACA conference since then. The thing about conference is I cannot put into words that experience of those 3 days of being with hundreds of other CNAs, expressing your pride, getting that recognition and that motivation from the NACA staff and the board of directors and the company showing their appreciation for CNAs by sending them to the conference. It's impossible to put that into words, that feeling that you have inside. The day that you get there and the day that you leave, you have a different feeling. Especially, Lori says there's two different people that need to be at CNA Fest. The ones that deserve to be there and the ones that need to be there. The ones that deserve to be there are the CNAs that have that positive attitude, looking to build that knowledge and those skills around our profession. And the ones that need to be there are the ones that really have no idea how much support is out there and how many CNAs really dig deep into our career and push it as far as we can. CNA Fest, one thing you guys are going to notice this year that is different from years before is that traditionally NACA has had it at a hotel, a big establishment. You'll see it at the Renaissance. It started with an M, I can't even think of the name of the hotel now, but everything has been on site. If you wanted to do something, you had to leave the campus to go do it. In Oklahoma City, you had to go down to Bricktown if you wanted to do activities outside of conference after the educational sessions were done. But this year, for the first year, we are doing it in Little Rock, Arkansas at a 4-H site. And so there's going to be on-site activities there for us to do. You guys can see the view. It's gorgeous. I personally cannot wait for this year. It's a whole other ball game. There's going to be all sorts of activities for us to do. I'd be happy with just sitting there and looking at the view. I'd be perfectly okay with that. But there is everything there that we're having breakout sessions, rock wall climbing, zip lining, kayaking, a bonfire hosted by the board of directors. And actually, right yesterday, our director of administrative services, Dane Henning, and our director of operations, Jeff Wellman, went down and took a tour of the site. And they were joined by several of the board members. There was Tina Roberts from Tennessee, Sherry Perry from Tennessee, Sam Maddox from Oklahoma, Sheena Bumpus from Oklahoma, and I always mess up Corinne's last name, but I'm going to try Corinne. Corinne Gantuitz from Missouri. All traveled down to the site in Little Rock, Arkansas to ask questions, make sure everything was set up okay, that where we were going to put what activities, everything, any questions that popped into our head are... I don't know if a technical advisor, I guess you call him, our productions guy, Gary, sent a list of questions, Gary Omart, down with them to ask about the setup for audio, the visual things that we're going to need, like the big screen, these big screens you guys see with the NACA logos and the logos for each individual conference that we've had in the past have all been planned out ahead of time. So these are just some of the questions that they're asking while they're down there, besides having a whole lot of fun. And we thank them for sending these pictures to us from there. And we're going to take a short break. And when we come back, we're going to let you guys know what kind of spirit and what kind of activities you should expect at this year's CNA Fest in Little Rock, Arkansas.
When you have satisfied and content CNAs, the care is better and you're going to have less nursing assistant turnover.
So many times I think they're just, you know, in the trenches and nobody hears, nobody cares about them. And it's not true. You know, it's simply not true. And this organization helps them gain that voice and helps them be heard.
We're awesome. And I'm going to hold my head high and I'm going to ride this magic carpet and I'm going to change the world. That's what NACA did for me.
For more information, visit us online at NACACNA.org or call 417-623-6049. From the heart A weekly segment with John Willard airs every Tuesday at 2:30 Central Time on CNA TV.
Welcome back to Katie in the Morning. So today we're talking about CNA Fest. What you should expect when you're coming to CNA Fest, first of all, we'll have the travel arrangements made from the airport and from the train station to the site, so you guys don't have to worry about how you're going to get there once you're there. There's the 2 days of education. There's keynote speakers already plugged in and ready to go. You'll see Meg Laporte there. She'll be talking about writing your own story as a CNA. Donna Adair will be there presenting her popcorn stories. We're going to have several breakout sessions the evening of the first night that we're there. That will include the bonfire that the board of directors is going to put on. And then the second day, of course, we'll have the Key to Quality Awards. All the food is provided. You guys don't have to worry about meals while you're there. We're going to set up hydration stations outside. So if you're outside doing the activities in the early evening, late afternoon, early evening, I should say, you won't have to worry about carrying around a bag with water bottles and that sort of thing in it. When it comes to spirit, people are asking, you know, what should I bring? Do I need to bring props? Do I need to, you know, bring stuff that I can make my own signs with? We encourage you to do that kind of stuff, but we do provide some things for you guys to kind of prop yourselves up with. In the NACA Pro Shop, you can find like the boomsticks, the pins. You'll get lanyards in your bags. We provide the t-shirt for the second day. The first day that you're there, you'll want to do like khakis or jeans, appropriate shorts, and then like a facility t-shirt or a dress blouse. And then the Key to Quality Awards are like a semi-formal to formal wear. And that experience is another experience all in itself. It's like the Grammys for CNAs. As far as spirit goes, people go all out for CNA Fest. I remember my first CNA Fest or my first NACA conference, I believe it was the Missouri Veterans Home that came. They had like the full out like tutus and like props that they were waving around the air, little megaphone type things. It's a crazy event. CNAs are like running all over the place, jumping off tables, just so proud and so happy to be in the presence of other CNAs, networking and problem solving and just having a great time. For those homes that have not registered and are planning on sending CNAs, we really encourage you to get in there and do so. The deadline for registration is June 25th. The Key to Quality Awards nominations is June 25th. And the essay scholarship entries is also, the deadline is June 25th. And that is a full paid free ride to CNA Fest. So any individual members, or even if you're not a member of NACA, you can get to CNA Fest fully paid by just entering your essay scholarship on the website at www.nacacareforce.org. You'll click on the little conference tab, go down to 2018, and then a little sidebar will pop up and click on the scholarship essay button. And that'll bring you to the screen to put your essay in. The question this year is, what are you doing now to change the profession in the future for CNAs? And it's just 300 to 500 words. We're not looking for grammar, punctuation, spelling. We're looking for passion. So if you go in there and tell us what you're doing on a daily basis to change the future for CNAs, you could very well win your free ride to CNA Fest. I hope to see all of you there. And I will see you guys right back here tomorrow at 10 a.m. for Katie in the Morning.